So one of the design trend that is getting popular in website building is bento grid or bento box. Basically, bento is a Japanese tiffin box, and each tiffin box has like multiple sections with different sizes. So I have two designs that I already made, which is I'm giving for like templates. So first is this one. So you could see this is like a landing page with bento grids, but all of them are like the same sizes. You could see, and you could actually get this template for free for Elementor from my websites. I have like lots of like Elementor templates that I make and give it for free. And the second one is this one, which is like different sizes, and you don't even need to make it the similar way. I'm just going to show you how you can make the containers be automatically doing this stuff. So let me show you guys. So if I go in the container like this, if I go into layout, and you could see it automatically changes it to the size that you want, and it automatically fixes it in the next section and automatically does it completely like this. And if you don't want to start from scratch, you could always get the templates and stuff, but I'm going to show you. Just ignore this, I was making another video that is how you can switch this with a button with Elementor, and that's for free too. So let me just show you how we can make the containers do this. So first thing that I want to show you is we will actually create one big container. I'll just make it, I guess, like 1300 pixels for box width. And in the inside that we need another container. Let's duplicate this one. We need to make the inside containers full width like this. And the main one, which is this one. So let's just name it like main, so that we know which we are clicking. I just hope we can like color code it. I don't know if we can color code it or not. But let me just choose the main container, make it row horizontal. And then both of this are full width. And basically if we check around here, we can choose whether to give them space between each one or not. I'm going to keep it default for now. And right now you could check that when I make this smaller, it actually does make this bigger automatically. But if I just duplicate this one and then duplicate this one, it just keeps on going in one sections. And obviously you could keep doing this one, like you could duplicate this one again and then make it have stuff like this. Like you will need to adjust it obviously. And you can keep making it like this with multiple sections. But I don't want to do it that way. So, okay, let me just create like a big container around here so that we have space between like the top part and the bottom part. So this one. So what we are going to do is we are going to actually enable something called wrap. And what it does is basically whenever the size of one container gets bigger than this section, which is like 1300 pixel, it basically takes itself to the next part. So you could see that right now this is like 47% and this one is like 100. So there's no place for it. So it will basically just warp it next size. It will not try to adjust the size. It will just basically take it to the next part so that it is to the accurate size that you have given here. So let me check something. So if we are at 47, if I'll make it like 43, or if I make it to 53, it will not work because, you know, we have gap. So we have actually like 20 pixel gap. So let me just reduce it like this. And you could see it automatically went there. Let me duplicate this one. And let me like duplicate another one. I can actually add color so that you guys can see it better. Right now we have these two containers, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to reduce the size of it a lot. Maybe I should first reduce the size of this thing. So I'll make it like 30. So right now it is 47, 21, which is like 68%, and then if I reduce it, it is automatically getting there. But now you're seeing another issue. So let's say I actually make it like this, but there's like bad space around here. So if I just add a color, well, it's not going to show because we have added box layout. So basically this much is the box layout for us. So we are getting bad spaces around here. So what we are going to do is we are going to add a thing called grow. So basically we will add grow thing to everything like this. Grow, and then grow like this. And what it's basically doing, that whenever there's like empty space left in that container, it will automatically grow to that size. So that if I just remove this, you could see it is making the empty size covered by this self because we have grow added here. But if we don't, it will not. And that's basically like the main gist of it, that if you just change it, let me also add grow around here. So if I actually just make it smaller, that it's going there, then it is automatically making it this size. And obviously you could use the previous step too, but I like to do this because when people are sizing and closing their browser or just bigger screen, it just looks better that way. So right now if I just make it bigger, it will go bigger like this. And in this one you could see that I have like a hover animation, and it's pretty easy to do. This is not even this is like a different tutorial, but I'll just show it in this one too. So basically you could see there's like main container like this, not like the main, like this one, the inner main container, and inside that I have another container like this. And that one has a thing called CSS, which you could actually get Elementor Pro from my description, or if you go to my site, which is like, if you go into recommended, you could actually just check my recommended stuff, which I show on my website like this. And you could click on Elementor Pro, and that way you could support me, or I'll add a direct link to the Elementor Pro in description too. But basically what we are doing is, we are making the inner container have opacity 0, and when we are hovering on it, we are making opacity 1. So let me quickly show you how you can do it on this part. So I'll add another container like this. Then I'll add, let's say, and I guess a text paragraph, and then an image. I don't know, I'll use this one. Make it like smaller, I guess. I can actually make the width of the whole container smaller like this, you know. And that's the best part. As soon as I made it smaller, this one popped up to fill up that area. So that the tiffin box always is like, the bento box is always in the same size always. I said always too many times. But let me create a hover effect. Sorry, a background color to show you what's happening, and a main container background color to like something like this. So you can see what's happening. There is a main container, sorry, not the main, not this main, but inside one that we are using for bento. And there's another container inside them which has the content like this. And for this one, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a CSS. So in this one, you could see I don't have the Elementor Pro, but I'm using another plugin, Royal Addons. I was just making a video to showcase which Elementor plugins are like good and not extra Elementor plugins. So let me just add like selector, add opacity to 0, and basically it just made it disappear. And then I'm going to add another thing, that is selector, and on hover I'll make it opacity to 1. So now when I hover, you could see it's basically adding that content between that. So this container is only showing when I'm hovering on it, and just add transition, I guess 0.3 seconds. So 0.3 seconds. And now we actually would have, I added transform, we needed transition. Okay, there we go. And you could see that the animation is actually working nicely. And you could see there is actually a space around here. So all you need to do is choose the inner container which has that all content, and then just remove the padding. And now you could see we basically have an animation which does the same stuff which is around here. And if I remove the padding around this one, you could see it just looks nice and everything just works perfectly. So you could see. And also when you click on it, it actually selects the inside container. So you have to use the navigator, which you could click on here to get it, and choose the inner containers to actually change stuff like this. And you could add any image, anything at all. Pretty easy, right?